of Jesus, because he first loved me. Oh, how I love Jesus.
Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh,
all it takes. Oh, how.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
If each and every one of us,
oh, how I love,
look at our life and see what Jesus brought us through and from.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
It's an individual thing.
Jesus, because
it's what he has done for you. That's why the song is so special. It's
oh, oh, how I love Jesus.
During your good days and your bad days.
How I love Jesus.
Your ups and your downs.
Oh,
we don't know what Jesus has done for you, but you do.
Because he first.
One more time. Oh, how I love Jesus. L-O-O.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
Say it like you mean it.
Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh,
amen. Please take note of this scripture. Peter said unto him, Lord, why cannot I follow thee now? I will lay down my life for thy sake. Jesus answered him, Wilt thou lay down thy life for my sake? Verily, verily, I say unto thee, the cock shall not crow till thou hast denied me thrice.
Yes, yes.
Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, ye may also be. I've read to you from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 37, 38, and then chapter 14, 1 through 4. May the Lord add a blessing to the reader, hearer, and doer of his word. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
You, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Friend,
he's my friend. He's my friend. He's my friend.
friend.
He's my 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 friend. I just want to thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just want to thank you, Lord.
Go ahead.
Amen. Let us pray. Our most gracious and heavenly Father.
Yes.
Just a few of your humble servants, Father God, coming to give you praise and glory and thanks this morning, Father God. We thank you, God, for your darling Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who died, bled, and rose on this Easter Sunday, Father God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for all the provisions that you've given us, Father God, the many blessings that we have and we take for granted, Father God. Thank you for health and strength and our family's love, Father God. Thank you for your love, Father God, and continue to watch over us and guide us and bless us, Father God. Bless all the churches that are opening in your namesake, Father God. Bless those who were trying to make it this morning and those who have made it, Father God.
Yes.
Bless the sick, Father God, the infirm, Father God, the incarcerated, Father God.
Yes.
Bless those who are out there and don't know you as their Savior, Father God. Bless them that they may come to the church house, Father God, asking, what must I do to be saved, Father God? Bless our leadership, Father God. Bless the speaker this morning. Bless our First Lady, Father God. Bless our entire church, Father God, to continue to watch over and guide us. Thanks again, and in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. The Lord is blessing me. Right now, oh, right now, you know the Lord is blessing me. Right now, oh, right now, you know he woke me up this morning and he started me on my way. Right now, oh,
right now,
the Lord is blessing me.
The Lord is blessing me.
Right now, oh, right now,
you know the Lord is blessing me.
Right now, oh, right now,
you know he woke me up this morning and he started me on my way. Hey, the Lord is blessing me right now.
Oh, right now.
One more time, the Lord is blessing me.
The Lord is blessing me.
Right now, oh, right now,
you know the Lord is blessing me.
Right now, oh, right now, right now.
Oh, right now.
Just the music, just the music. The Lord is blessing me. The Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. You know the Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. You know He woke me up this morning, and He started me on my way. Hey, the Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. Amen. Thank you for joining in our devotion. Now we will have the entrance of our youth. Amen. Easter parade, mom.
She wants music, some fast music.
If you're singing in the choir, go to the choir stand. If not, have a seat with your parents. Thank you. Good morning, good morning. We're gonna get ready and do our Easter speeches. The kids have not done live speeches in about 4 years now, but they wanted to do live this year, so please support our babies. Okay, first on deck, we have the brothers, three brothers, Aubrey, Carter, and Asher. Come on to me. We're going to have the big brother first, Aubrey Jackson, with Easter Joy and Praise.
Amen. Easter is time for joy and praise from out the darkness into the sun rays. Jesus moved the boulder and returned to forgive all sins. That's when our joy in Christ can really begin. The light on Jesus truly never ends. He suffered so our souls would be able to mend. With joy and praise on Easter, we rejoice and praise Him together. Praise Him together with the strength of one voice.
Amen. On Easter Day, the lilies bloom, triumphant, risen from their tomb. The bulbs have undergone rebirth from the silence of the earth, symbolically to tell all men that Christ the Savior lives again. The angels peer in white as they have come and rolled the stone away. And with the lifting on the stone, the shadow of the cross is gone.
Now we have their sister, Ashton, will remember God's gift.
May your Easter be happy. May your day be bright. May you enjoy the treats and sweets delight. But remember the meaning. Remember God's gift. Remember the restoration, may your soul uplift.
Now we have Jamila Johnson, he lives.
Come on.
Happy Easter, hallelujah, Jesus Christ, he lives. Surfing the sea, eternal life he gets.
Amen. Okay, now we have another sister and brother. We're going to have I Will Trust by Carmelo. Come on, Carmelo.
Easter morning, bright and fair, tells me of God's love and care. Flowers that were gone from view and now coming blue and new. Though God's face I do not see, I'll trust His care for me.
Now we have Jesus is Good by Olive Allen. Come on.
Jesus is good, Jesus is great. Jesus died for us, oh what a fate. He rose again on this Easter Sunday. He loves us so much, so let's praise Him today.
Now we have The Life of Easter by Evan Wright.
The Life of Easter. Easter comes in the spring, bringing life to everything. It reminds me of Easter past, when Jesus brought us life to last. For on Easter, Jesus, there's life all around. To marvel and behold, there's new life for us even as we grow old. For on Easter, Jesus rose, defeating death for good, bringing eternal life to the world, like only He could, truth be told.
Now we have The Cross by Sky Glover.
The Cross. I know in life we all go through a lot of hurt and pain, but we need to think of Jesus Christ on the cross with all our shame. For as our Lord was hanging there, He bore our sin and doubts, and the brokenness that bound our lives as His precious blood poured out. And in the blood that flowed that day is forgiveness for all our sin. For only Christ's blood is able to cleanse the deepest stain within. But oh, the pain that he went through and suffering on his own. For even the Father turned his face and he was left to die alone. We could never imagine the anguish Jesus endured upon the cross and the love expressed in his dying breath when all we did was scoff. And nothing at all we'd ever go through could possibly compare to the horror that the cross portrays of our sin, our hurts, and fears. For the cross of Christ reconciled us to our Father God above, and the Holy Spirit empowers us to walk in transforming love. Thank you.
Now we have The Resurrection by Lauren Glover.
We hold so close to our hearts the cross where Jesus died, but so much more than the bloodstained cross is that Jesus came back to life. The stone's been rolled away, the tomb lay open and bare. They looked for him, and then the angel said that he is no longer here. Oh, what joy they must have felt to see him just once more, to eat with him, to drink with him, to receive him back as Lord. So much did he accomplish through his death upon the cross and his rising from the dead. He reconciled us back to God. Nothing else could bridge the gap. That sin was wrenched apart. Now we can freely go to God and receive Christ in our hearts.
And now we have Madison Reed with the Lamb of God.
Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away our sin. He came, the sinless Son of God, to cleanse our hearts within. He hung upon the blood-stained cross, thinking of you and me, dying like some hardened criminal, his body in agony. His blood flowed down from the cross, his body tormented with pain. He cried out to his heavenly Father, but it seemed no answer came. People stood and jeered at him, mocking to the end. Who Jesus was and why he came, they couldn't comprehend. Their hearts were indifferent to the Lord, their consciences grew ever cold. His mother watched on, unable to bear it, as the sword pierced through her soul. As you try to grasp this picture, the pain that Christ went through, remember that day you were on his mind. He endured it all for you. Just so you could know his love and forgiveness for your sins, to know his resurrection power and to have his life within. He cares that much about your life. He endured the cross for you. Like those who jeered or those who loved, with Jesus, what will you do?
That concludes our program. All my praise dancers, meet me in the back.
Good morning. Let's give those children another hand. Well, I was going to do the announcements for today, but I don't have them in my front. Thank you. All right, we would like to take this time to welcome our visitors and let you know we're so happy that you chose to worship here with us this morning. And anytime our doors are open, you're always welcome. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. These are your announcements for today, March 31st. The Top Ladies of Distinction Incorporated Cardinal Chapter will honor Mothers of the Year at a luncheon on May the 11th at 11 a.m. at the Renaissance St. Louis Airport Hotel. The tickets are $70. And our own Sister Verna Reed will be honored as a 2024 Mother of the Year. Yeah. If you would like to attend this event, please see Sister Reed, myself, or Sister Hicks for tickets. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Our upcoming events, we have our First Ladies Day, April the 21st. Amen?
Amen.
Our pastor's anniversary is April the 28th, and Mother's Day is May the 12th. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Our sick and shut-in, Sister Willoughby Blackman, Sister Ruby Kane, Brother Caleb Davis, Brother Jonathan Cotton, and Reverend James Page. And we would like to thank the Lord for allowing Sister Sharon Green and Brother Richard Green to be here with us this morning. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Please, ma'am, please, sir, continue to pray for those on our sick and shut-in list and call them and let them know you're thinking of them. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Our thought for the day. Today we celebrate Resurrection Day, and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is the reason. We do not celebrate the resurrection of our Easter Bunny. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Our pastor observation. I have been told that I take all of the fun out of Easter. I responded that this is not a fun situation, but the seriousness of where my soul will spend eternity. Chickens and eggs, rabbits and candy has nothing to do with the salvation, and God is the someone whom you take seriously. What he said, he meant. And what he meant, he said. And he proved it by sacrificing his son to the death on the cross, that we might have eternal life. Now I ask you, what's fun or funny when someone dies? May God bless you, Pastor Reed. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Our church motto, everywhere you go,
thank the Lord.
And don't go anywhere.
You can't take the Lord.
Amen. We would like to take this time to wish everyone who has a birthday in the month of March a very happy birthday. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Order of service. Sunday school is every Sunday at 8:45 a.m. Morning worship is at 10 a.m. And communion is the first Sunday during morning service. Choir rehearsal schedule. There will be no choir rehearsal this Thursday. Oh. Amen. These have been your announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Sister Beverly Allen is your announcing clerk. And Reverend Robert Reed, he is our pastor. Amen. Amen. Our sick and shut-in list. I'm sorry, our special prayer request list. Brother Lionel Hubbard, Sister Octavia Stovall, Sister Lorraine Darden, Deacon Lorman Williams, Sister Willoughby Blackman, Brother Salton Hubbard, Brother Liddell Hubbard, Sister Denise Jackson, Sister Jennifer Kane, Sister Ruby Kane, Sister Muriel Yandel, Brother Caleb Davis, Sister Peggy Stewart, Brother Jonathan Cotton, Sister Sandra Johnson, Sister Felinda Darden, Sister Lurie Hubbard, Sister Sharon Green, Brother Richard Green, Reverend James Page, and Sister Robin Rich and family. Please, ma'am, please, sir, continue to pray for those on our special prayer request list. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
It is no secret what God can do. What he has done for others, he will surely do for you. Choir, It is. Every day is a precious day, and every day the Lord allow you to wake up, you need to start counting your blessings. The holiday week has its special moments, but truly every day is a special moment. And members know how I am. So 4 o'clock in the morning I get a text, and it says to me, "Pastor, did you see the bridge in Baltimore?" And I begin to think, I don't know how many of you cross a bridge every day, but this week you better be glad it was Baltimore and not St. Louis. Just because it happened there don't mean it can't happen here. Oh, let me say it again. Every day you get up, you ought to thank the Lord for your blessing. It happened here a few years ago, but the bridge did not fall into the water. I said, folk know how I am. For those of you who don't know how I am, I have a problem crossing bridges. However, there is a bridge that will take you over troubled waters. There is a bridge that a ship cannot knock down. There is a bridge that whenever you have sorrow, whenever you have problems, whenever you have any type of situation in your life, you can cross that bridge, go over and talk to God, and that bridge is called prayer. You may have something that you need to talk to him about right now. Somebody just got over sickness. And let me say this again. If you're not in a storm, you just got out of a storm. And if you didn't have a storm, you're on your way to a storm. And however you go, a storm is going to occur in your life. And when that storm comes, you need to know how to get over to the other side of that bridge and tell the Lord whatever it is that you need to tell him. It's prayer time now, y'all. Heads bowed. Eyes shut off to the world. And the Master, he is in charge. And whatever you need to tell him, Sister B. Blackman and Brother Lenny L. Hubbard, Lord, I thank you. Octavia is here with us today. Sister Robin Rich. And all these prayers that are going up right now, one over here, one over there, one back there, one right here. In the name of Jesus, we came victory over all of them. Amen.
Missionary Baptist Church. Would a man rob God? But ye say, wherein have we robbed thee? Bring ye all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house. But this I say, he that soweth sparingly shall reap sparingly. So let him give, not grudgingly of necessity. Amen. We're in the hands of our ushers. Thank you.
gentlemen, please hold on to your seats as we present Jesus Angels. another hand.
Amen. I believe we can do better. Let's give our babies a hand. Well, come on, y'all, take a bow. Come on, take a bow.
Thank you.
The Gospel according to Matthew chapter 27. Giving honor to the Most High God who has allowed us to be here in the land of the dying, headed toward the land of the living. To these, our young people who have done a tremendous job today. Ushers, deacons, trustees, and all you my father's children, I promise you I will let you go real early. Matthew chapter 27, starting at verse 19 and continuing to verse 22, therein you'll find these words. And when he sat down on the judgment seat, his wife sent unto him, saying, "Have thou nothing to do with this just man? For I have suffered many things this day in a dream because of him." But the chief priests and elders persuaded the multitude that they should ask Barabbas and destroy Jesus. The governor answered and said unto them, "Whether of the twain will ye that I release unto you?" They said, "Barabbas." Pilate said unto them, "What shall I do then with Jesus, which is called Christ?" They all said unto him, "Let him be crucified." Read that 22nd again. Pilate said unto them, "What shall I do then with Jesus, which is called Christ?" And from those passages of scripture, I want to talk about the answer is not found in the crowd. The answer is not found in the crowd. Last Sunday, I told you about two crowds that welcomed him in to Jerusalem as he rode in on the colt. The crowd that was cheering so loud that the Pharisees told Jesus to make them hush up, be quiet. And you remember that reply, Jesus said, "If these hold their peace, the very rocks will cry out." But you gotta hold on to that. I'm gonna come back to it in a minute. But you gotta be careful about a crowd. The same crowd that you run with, you don't watch it, it'll turn on you. By today's standards, we can't get in a crowd no more. We can't go to the ball game. Somebody threatening to blow up the building. We can't go to the parade. Somebody there shooting inside the parade. I remember when I was y'all's age, I used to tell my mama, "I gotta go, because everybody gonna be there." My mama said to me, "If everybody jump off the bridge, you gonna jump too?" Yeah. You don't need necessarily to be in a crowd, especially the wrong crowd. Can I tell y'all about my birthday party? Last week I told you about my birthday. This week I tell you about my birthday party. There were only two people invited to my party. Brother Glover, I was one. Y'all know who the other one was. Amen. I didn't have to have a whole lot of fanfare, cake and prizes and the likes of at my party. I didn't need a crowd at my party. Wasn't it good back there in the 60s? Back in the 60s. When we used to have house parties. And everybody would come. And we just have a good time. You can't do that now. Yeah, ain't no telling who coming or what they bringing. Even down to the point where my little kids enjoying themselves at Chuck E. Cheese or wherever they go. And then my big kids ain't got enough sense to let my little kids enjoy themselves. Yeah, you can't hang around with a crowd no more. When a crowd turns violent, it's no longer a crowd, but it's a mob. And I told you about the two crowds earlier, and the first crowd were the disciples. And the second crowd were those with whom Jesus had blessed. You have to watch that crowd, because a crowd will become a turncoat. They will turn on you sometimes in a heartbeat. But the thing I don't like about the crowd more so than anything is that we suffer peer pressure in the crowd. Y'all didn't get it. Okay, let me do it like this here. Let me go down to the ball game. Let me be a Dodgers fan. Let there be 53,000 Cardinal fans down there. And I'm a Dodger fan. You let me root for the Dodgers, and the crowd gonna soon change my mind. With all the words of threat that come back to the seat where I am sitting. So the next time I go, I just won't bother to wear my Dodger blue or root for my Dodger team. That's peer pressure. If you believe in something, you ought not let nobody change your mind. If you stand for something, you ought to stand for what you stand for and stand on what you stand for, regardless of what the crowd around you might think. I'm finna go somewhere. Y'all can vote for that hairpiece you want to. You ain't gonna change my mind. Ain't no way I'm gonna get no orange on my voting ticket. Oh no, y'all didn't get that. Okay. See, a crowd has to, by today's standard, has the ability of being unsafe. But children, this ain't the first time that a crowd messed up. Now, you can go all the way back to the book of Exodus and find a crowd that has done wrong because they felt like they had a necessity somewhere else. Watch me. You remember when the children of Israel was out in the wilderness with Moses and he was leading them to the promised land? Do you remember when he had delivered them from bondage, when they were under Pharaoh while they were down in Egypt and they were not free and they were slaves? Do you remember that same crowd of 600,000 men, not counting women and children, begin to jump on Moses? Now, I'm telling you, they jumped on Moses because they got them out there in the wilderness. But do you remember what for? Watch me. Would you rather have fried chicken or be a slave? I'm going to do that again because y'all didn't catch it. Do you remember what for? Would you prefer a T-bone steak, or would you rather be a slave? Huh? The children of Israel, go read your scripture, y'all, was jumping on Moses, because of their taste buds. You didn't see it. Moses. Yeah. We've been eating this manna ever since we've been out here. And we could have stayed down in Egypt. Now I'm going to ask the question again. Would you really have fried chicken or would you rather be a slave? We could have stayed down in Egypt, and if we stayed down in Egypt, we'd have had what we wanted. So therefore Moses had to go crying to the Lord, but that's a sermon for another day. Here we find another crowd. Let me introduce you to the participants in this scripture. You already know the master, but here is a guy by the name of Pilate, and he is the governor here down in Jerusalem. Here is another character named Herod, but he rules over in Galilee. And then they're sitting there is a crowd of people outside. Now the reason why this crowd is outside because of what we just got through doing, celebrating Passover. And they would all go back to Jerusalem and there they would celebrate. I got a point I can make here. And here comes the priest. And they tell the crowd, in accordance to Roman custom, they're going to turn one somebody loose. One prisoner will be turned loose. You know how when the governor and the president get ready to leave office, and they pardon a bunch of folk? This ain't just started, y'all. This started back at the Passover. And so they said, we gonna turn one somebody loose. Now, about 5 hours earlier, they had arrested Jesus and brought him before Pilate. Pilate looked around there and said, well, what did he do? Oh, y'all, that's crazy. He healed sick folk. He fed hungry folk. He relieved troubled folk. And you arrested him for that? But he did some of it on a Sabbath day. And you arrested him for that? We don't care. Now, children, let me help you understand. The priest knew that when Christ came, they would have to give up their position as being the high priest, because he was the head high priest. Having studied the scripture, they knew when he got here whom he was. Let me read it again. Look inside of here and you'll see Pilate asked him in the four Gospels of the Canaan. Pilate asked him, "Art thou king of the Jews?" Remember on last week, I told you how they kept up with the genealogy of Christ to know whom he would be when he got here. From the time Nebuchadnezzar went down from Babylon and took their king off the throne, they kept up with their roots so that they would know who the king would be. And Pilate asked him a question, "Art thou king of the Jews?" He said, "You say it." Well, Pilate was satisfied and he was ready to let Christ go. But here comes the point I need to make. Here go the priests going to the people and saying, "Pilate's gonna come ask you if you wish to let Jesus go. You tell him to crucify Jesus and turn Barabbas loose. Now, children, that's where I got a problem. Because the priest at that time would be the preacher of this time. And any time a priest or a preacher take the scripture and lie to you with it, you need to find you another preacher. Any time a preacher take the scripture and don't tell you what thus said the Lord, irregardless of what your feelings is, I don't care what that preacher said. You ain't got to care. All you got to do, what did he tell us the other week? He said God said it, God wrote it, and God meant it. And if God said right and wrote and meant what he said, and thus said the preacher or the priest who was telling you what God said, then that's the priest you need to listen to. But anytime somebody can take Genesis to Exodus, twist it like you do a dish rag, and make it come out like they want it to, you need to find somebody else. And the priests went told the people, when Pilate come ask you, hold it, y'all don't know who Pilate is, okay? The children of Israel are now under Roman authority. They have no king of their own. They have no president of their own. And even though they want to follow Mosaic law, they cannot do it without Roman authority. Pilate was not Jewish. Herod was not Jewish. They were Roman. And in being Roman, when the priests wanted to stone Jesus, they would have to get Pilate's authority. Now they want to crucify him. And in order to do so, they got to get Pilate's authority. So they get up and go down to Pilate and take Jesus and have him arrested. When the charges are brought forth, it is found that Jesus had done nothing worthy of being crucified for. Well, y'all, not only Pilate, but his wife woke up all through the night. Every time she shut her eyes, she had nightmares about Jesus being crucified. She woke up and sent word to her husband, have nothing to do with this just man. Well, y'all, Pilate decided to let Jesus go. But the priest told the audience, when he come and ask y'all, tell him to crucify. So the crowd sitting beneath Pilate's window, whenever Pilate would come and ask them, they said, crucify Jesus. Well, I got a thief here by the name of Barabbas. He's been stealing all his life. I got a thief by the name of Barabbas who wait till you leave and go in your house. I got a thief by the name of Barabbas. He goes in your pocket while your attention is somewhere else. I got a thief named Barabbas. He will stick a 45 in your side and take your billfold out your pocket. I got a thief named Barabbas, and what you want me to do with him versus this man called Jesus. I heard the crowd saying, crucify Jesus and give us Barabbas. You know something wrong with a person when they choose some malefactor over a savior. Something wrong with a person when they choose somebody who gonna do them harm versus somebody who gonna do them well. Well, they said, well, we'll take Jesus and crucify him. But look, y'all, before they crucified my Lord and Savior, they led him to somebody's back room. And when they got there, they took a whip and started lashing him across his back. Look, y'all, The whip had a tip on the end that when it lashed across the back, it would come round toward the front and snap him in his chest before it would turn loose. And they did that to him 39 times, one time for each book in the Old Testament. If I took out a little time here, I tell you, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John were not involved in this. But this was Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, 1st and 2nd Kings, Esther, Nehemiah. Well, y'all, you get the picture. And they whipped him all night long. And then early the next morning, they said, if you are the king of Judah, they took a crown of thorns and braced them down on his head. The thorns pierced into his skull, and blood started to trickle out. And then they put an old rugged cross on his shoulder and marched him up to Golgotha Hill. I come to tell y'all that the crowd that was there Sunday is right here again right now. But this time, the crowd is different. This time, the baker is there because he couldn't make no money when he fed the 5,000. This time, the undertaker is there because he couldn't make no money when he raised them from the dead. This time, the doctor is there because he healed the sick. And the crowd said, crucify him. They took him up that hill, and when they got up there, they nailed him to a cross, and being on a cross, they didn't kill him. My Bible tells me he gave up the ghost. In other words, he died on a hill called Calvary. He died that Friday morning, right early. Right early. It was early, the third day morning. Now what makes that so important to me and you? I'm going to tell you right now, if you read Exodus 20, the Bible says, remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. But that was a law that he gave to the Jews. And from Exodus to Malachi, you and I are not included. But Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, when he got up that Sunday morning, that means that you and I got a right to the tree of life. That means that you and I get a chance to go to glory. And that's why every Sunday you come to Bell Grove, you gonna hear me say, hey! The doors. Of the church open. If there be somebody here today because Jesus rose, that third day morning, that give you a